I could draw, but the main focus of my table now is going to be the comic books that I produced in my imprint, Vantage Announce Productions. I've been self-publishing for like 5 years and nobody knew. Nobody. So I had to kind of let the pixel art stuff go. It was fun, it was popular, but...
I remember your books. Your books were on the table.
Everybody knows the David guy, but now I want to be known as a comic book guy.
So. Alright, so then tell us about all your books, one by one.
Alright, we'll start over here on this side. This is Wonder Care Presents The Kindergartens. It's an all-ages title. It's essentially Muppet Babies meets the Justice League. It is all kinds of super cute. I love this particular book. I do it with Justin Castaneda. He's a fantastic creator outside of Chicago area. Very awesome guy. We have Origins Unknown. This is more of our teen-friendly book. I did this one with Jacob Newell. The idea is that these are three short stories where they have a similar theme. The protagonist learns a hidden secret of heritage, and it changes their future and possibly what is the world. We have The Trouble with Love. This one's probably the most critically acclaimed book on the table. What we have is a Superman analog. His name is Apex Prime. He's got a wife, he's got a family, and he falls in love with someone else. So years later, his son comes to him and says, "Dad, what happened?" And he just kind of explains how he fell in love, as much as he tried to fight it, he can't fight his feelings. And, as strong as he is, love is a far more powerful force. So it's just kind of a very interesting sort of way of looking at relationships in the superhero context. I love it. Then we have The Samaritan, which is a bit more mature read. What we have is an urban take on the superhero. Imagine a character who is high-level powers, but rather than, wearing a costume or having a code name, he just moves into a crime-ridden area and starts systematically cleaning it up. And he's just like all about, like, I need to fix this. And he does so aggressively, if need be. This one is definitely the best seller. We've got it's 7 issues total over 3 books. So this one's like 5-7, the other one was 2-4, and then we have issue 1. We've got a lot of books, we got a range of stuff.
So what else is coming out?
So we've got Wonder Care Presents The Kindergartens number 3, that's coming out end of this month, middle of next month. Then also towards the end of this month, we have another mature title called Old Crazy and the 40 Ounces of Death. Yes, that one is my love letter to Quentin Tarantino / Stan Jackson. The artwork for it is gorgeous, though. Oh my God, I did that one. His name is Brian Moss, he's the artist. It was another guy from Columbus with me. Insanity. Love this stuff. Oh, love it. Love it.
What about Trouble with Love was a one-shot?
Yes, this one's a one-shot. However, we do have a follow-up. Harold Edge, he's my artist on this one, and we're doing a follow-up called Never Too Late that I've started writing now. So hopefully we'll get issue 1 out by the end of this year. That's the goal. We'll see. So yeah.
Alright, so guys, where can we find these books?
You can find it all online. You can find it in Comixology. You can find some on Indie Planet. You can find some on Amazon. Definitely go to my site, vantagegenhouse.blogspot.com. You'll find everything there.
Exactly. That's what I need.
Oh yeah.
Alright guys. So wait. This is New York Comic Con Special Edition.
Yes.
So I'm doing special questions for everybody.
Oh.
Now, you have special artwork,
yes.
Writing. How did you come into writing? Like, when did you find out in life that, hey, I like writing, I have a story I want to tell? And when did artwork, with the pixelated artwork and art, come into play also? What the origin of this?
That's a good question. All right, so the writing part happened when I was like 13. Like, I was such a fan of the books that I was reading, I wanted to create my own stories. So when I was 13, I started coming up with different ideas that are just now starting to see fruition. So that's where the writing came in. The pixel art, though, that came in from me stepping off to do shows on my own, but being totally, like, scared to go up against some of my friends who are way better illustrators than me. So I decided to do something like pixel art that would kind of be different but cool, and I did it at a time when, like, nobody was really doing pixel art stuff, so I was, like, kind of ahead of the curve.
Explosion.
Yeah, it was, like, huge. So I got really, really lucky with that one, but that's where it all came from, man. Like, this one was out of fear, this one's out of love, so...
It starts with fear and it always ends with love.
It's how it is. Absolutely.
All right. So that's it for this interview, guys. Thank you so much
for
this interview.
Absolutely.
Looking forward to checking out more of your books.